Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir. Today I'm with another Shopify customization tutorial for you guys. And in this tutorial, we will make our product page look good by adding a read more button. So if you have a product page which has huge description like this, and you are seeing a lot of white space in your product page and you want to display all of the specification and all of the details about the product, what you can do is add a small code, which I'm gonna show you how. And after doing that, you will be able to add a read more button. So when someone click on it, it will show all of the remaining product info. And when you click again on it, it will hide all of that info. So if you want to learn that, stick to the tutorial. Make sure to subscribe the channel, please, please, because it's going to support me to create more videos for you guys. And don't forget to like and comment. Okay, let's get into the code. So guys, that's how originally the product with long description page should look like. So there will be a lot of empty space when you add a multi-line long description to your product page. Now, what we're gonna do, we'll first go to the backend of our Shopify store in order to implement the read more button, which I showed you guys. Okay, from admin, click on online store. From online store, as you can see, we are doing that on Dawn theme. It's the latest version, which is 6.0.2. Now click on actions and edit code. Before editing the code, duplicate your theme if you are working on a live theme. Once you duplicate, you will have a copy of Dawn like this, which you can revert it back easily if you add a wrong code or mess up anyway, right? So click on actions and then edit code. From there, go to your theme.liquid file. And in our theme.liquid file, we will add jQuery. So search for jQuery CDN. And that's the link on the top. And from there, you can add the latest minified version. So click on minified here and copy this script, copy to clipboard, and paste it under head. So I'm gonna paste it on line number 9 and click save. Okay, once adding jQuery script, I'll add another jQuery code, which I have created for you guys. So that's the code which I'm going to copy and paste. Don't worry about the code. I'll add a blog post link in YouTube video description where you can find all of the codes. Okay. I think I am doing something wrong. /script. Okay, here we go. Now click on save. And now we'll go to our product edit page where we need to add the read more button. Okay, I'm going to go back to the dashboard of Shopify. And from products, I'll go to the specific product where I need to add the read more button. So that's the product. And as you can see, we have all of the description showing up here. Now, if you have your description showing up in a div, you don't need to worry about creating a new div. But if you don't have a div, you will need to create a new div and add it. Give the class to div read-more. So that's the class which you want to add in your div for your product description. And once you do that, we will add our read more button. So guys, we will give our button class of show hide read more. Make sure to don't do any mistake on classes. We added a div where we added all of our product description with the class of read more. and we created our read more button with the class of show underscore height. Okay, now hit save. And now let's preview our product to see how it looks. Okay, here we have our read more button. When you click on it, it shows all the description, and when you click on read less, it will hide all of it. But now, as you can see, we have the cursor which is showing like a stop sign, which is not good, and read more button is not prominent enough. Now, in order to fix that, we will need to add some CSS. And now let's go back again to our online store. Click on actions and then edit code. And from there, search for base.css. In this CSS file, we will be adding some CSS code to style our read more button. So I'm gonna scroll down on the bottom and add some CSS. So here's the CSS. Again, don't worry about the code. I'll add the blog post link where you will find all of the codes. Okay, so this code will basically just change the cursor and add some font weight, add some text decoration. Okay, we have this line duplicate. Remove that and increase the font size. Okay, now hit save. And go back to our product and hit refresh. Okay, here you can see our button is more prominent, and when you click on it, it will show up all the description, and when you click read less, it will hide all of it. But ideally, we should have one or two lines showing on top of that button, which will show the users that there is actually a description of the product to read. And then they, if they are interested, they'll click read more. If not, they'll just go through with it. Okay, now for that, I'm gonna go back to my product backend. That's the product. Go back to the code. And now simply what you can do is copy few lines, hood it, remove it from the div and add it above our read more button. That's it. And ideally we should have that within div as well, and hit save. And now one more time, go back to your product page and hit refresh. Okay, let's do it one more time. Okay, had to refresh it multiple times to clear the cache or something, right? Okay, so as you can see, we have few lines of product description showing up, and when we click on read more here, it shows the rest of the description. And when we again click on that button, it will remove it. Okay, let's check it out on our mobile version. So that's how our product page in mobile looks like. And when we click on read more, as you can see, it scrolls down with the complete product description. Read more, read less. Cool. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and share it if possible if you like the video. Until next video, have a great day.